I decided to go down the private chef route because it was something that I really enjoyed doing. After the MasterChef experience, I had an opportunity where I could cook for a family and go to their home, and I really enjoyed it. And at the time, I was working in a restaurant, a 2-Michelin-star restaurant, which was really great. I learned so much even just from the 4 months that I was working there. And for me, I just felt happier going to people's homes and cooking for 8 people. It's such a lovely experience. You get to be involved with them. You get to see their faces when they're happy, when they've finished their meal. You know, you get all the feedback from them. It's so great because you get to meet new people all the time. Today I'm going to be making for you a steak tartare. So in my beef tartare dish, we've got 70-day aged sirloin steak. Because it's been aged, you know, it's just such good quality beef. Texture is nice, you know, it's tender, it's not chewy at all. The fat is minimal in this part. The 70-day aged sirloin is very important because it has that mature taste to it. And because it's been dry aged in a salt chamber, it kind of takes that wetness away from it. So when you do dice it, you get the perfect diced steak. All I've done with the steak is I've removed the fat off of the edge of the steak and rendered it down in the pan. That releases all the fat, and by roasting it, you're given that extra kind of nutty taste. Then I remove the fat from the pan, keep the remaining liquid fat, and then add my croutons. So then I'm kind of creating like a beef dripping crouton, and you're using all the flavour from the steak and compacting it in this crispy crouton, which is then later on going to be placed on top of the steak tartare. I've also got some artichoke crisps, which works really, really well with beef, and they've just been sliced really thinly and fried in a little bit of vegetable oil, seasoned with a bit of salt right at the end. For the base of the beef tartare, we've got shallots, gherkins, Arran mustard, which is a very thick grain of mustard, so it gives it a bit more texture in the actual mix, chives for a bit of freshness, ketchup, Worcestershire sauce and Tabasco for a little bit of heat. And then we just mix that really gently together, just so that we don't break down the meat. When we come to plating up, we've got a truffle mayonnaise, which I've just made with truffle oil. Just taken a golden egg yolk, you know, emulsifying the egg with a little bit of vinegar. I've used a slightly sweeter vinegar on this occasion, just to take away the bitterness from it. Brings a slight sweeter element to the dish as well. Adding your truffle oil really slowly, whisking it in, and a little bit of salt at the end. It's really, really important to use good quality eggs, in my opinion. As well as that, we've got a mushroom ketchup just to top it off, and the mushrooms work really, really well with the beef. It gives it that kind of umami taste. I've used all the wastage basically from this week's cooking. We finish it off with a little bit of nasturtium, which gives it that little heat, kind of like a horseradish taste. And that's it. And it's very, very simple, not too complicated, and the flavours all work really, really well together. I think it's really, really important to have a great relationship with your butcher supplier, because you know where the product's coming from, you know the quality of the product, better the quality of the meat, the better the end result will be. It comes down to taste at the end of the day. It's good to know, you know, where it's come from, because you can then explain that to your customers. They know what they're paying for. If they're paying for a good quality piece of meat, that is exactly what they should get.